Onto the campaign trail, Bongbo Marcos is joined by a key ally turned foe of his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos. Former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, who is celebrating his 98th birthday, was at the opening of Marcos's campaign headquarters in Cagayan. The happy birthday song was even played as Enrile stepped on stage. Enrile served as the defense minister during the martial law era. He later withdrew his support for then-President Marcos and took part in the EDSA revolution that ousted the strongman. Last November, the Enrile family officially endorsed Marcos Jr. after a meeting in Makati City. Meanwhile, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno and his running mate, Dr. Willie Ong, wooed voters in Calbayog City in Samar Province. Their day began with a courtesy call to Calbayog City Mayor Diego Rivera. This is the first time that the Moreno-Ong tandem and their Senate slate took their campaign outside Luzon since the official campaign period began last week.
Philippine Health Secretary Francisco Duque warns campaign rallies could become COVID super spreader events. So far, Duque says campaign sorties are not yet causing a COVID surge, but he urges candidates to be examples to their supporters and follow minimum health protocols.
Dahil hindi po pwede na magiging pabaya tayo rito, dahil sigurado magiging super spreader events ito, mababalik na naman tayo sa mas mataas na alert level status, and we don't like that anymore. Nananawagan ako sa lahat ng mga kandidato, makipag-ugnayan, magsagawa ng mga engineering controls. Ano ba ang halimbawa ng engineering control? Pagka sa isang rally, no, ay may mga entrance sila, halimbawa sa isang coliseum, no? Dapat isa lang yung entry points, no? Tapos hiwala yung exit points. Dapat may mga alcohol sanitizer dispensing units.
As for the local government of Parañaque City, it vows to put an immediate stop to political rallies found to be violating health protocols. City Mayor Edwin Olivares calls on candidates to coordinate with local officials for the implementation of protocols.
Pag-ugnayan naman sa LGU yung ating mga rallies, yung mga sorties ng mga ating mga political party at minomonitor natin yon at para masunod yung ating guidelines na binigay ng COMELEC. As Parañaque is concerned, kapag di siya sumunod, patitigil namin. Patitigil namin yung rally.
A clarification from the spiritual advisor of Catholic Charismatic Group El Shaddai. Most Reverend Bishop Teodoro Bacani says the group has not endorsed any presidential and vice presidential candidates for the May elections. He says Brother Mike Velarde's endorsement of presidential aspirant Bongbo Marcos and his running mate Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio is personal. Bacani claims El Shaddai elders were not consulted about Velarde's move. He also slams Velarde for supporting Marcos.
Sa palagay ko, mali ang kanyang pag-endorse. It's downright wrong. Alam naman natin ang record nila, no? Hanggang ngayon ay hindi pa nag-apologize ang mga Marcos doon sa ginawang mga katiwalian noong nakaraan. Never again, Marcos. Except if he says, I am sorry for what my father did and we will return whatever money has not yet been returned to the Philippine government and to the Philippines. Bishop.
Meanwhile, the Catholic Church is leaving it up to the faithful to discern whom they think deserves their vote. Father Antonio Labiao Jr. of the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines says the church is willing to assist Filipino Catholics to get to know their candidates better. He also explained why the church has not endorsed any candidate yet.
As a church, that's very clear, we cannot be neutral. But it's a different question when we endorse a candidate. When we endorse a candidate, that should be a product of a communal discernment. If a candidate passes the criteria, the standard that we have put up for a good candidate to run this country, and we encourage our lay people to make also a stand.
Poll watchdog Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting, or the PPCRV, assures the public safeguards in the automated election system are in place. PPCRV's chairperson Myla Villanueva says, apart from the source code reviews, their team is also rigorously verifying the electronic copies the vote counting machines send to their transparency server. But Villanueva admits cheating takes place even before the election begins.
Unfortunately, we are hearing a lot of issues on vote buying. And, you know, it's very difficult for PPCRV alone to catch that or to report it. I think it has to be a national effort. But we're hearing a lot of big numbers being offered to people and families, in fact. So that's very sad. That's volunteer poll watchers, that we try our best to guard the vote, but it really is outside now the precincts that these are happening.
The poll watchdog now calls for more volunteers to help them monitor and manage the upcoming election.